Welcome to ESC TV in London. I am Valentina Kutyipra from the University of Rochester, Rochester, New York. And I have Jeroen Fenlet with me from Leiden University, the Netherlands. And today we are going to discuss his poster presentation entitled Critical Progressive Activation Delay is Associated with Polymorphic Ventricular Tachycardia in Non-ischemic Cardiomyopathy. So Dr. Fenlet, can you please summarize the major findings of your study?
Yeah, sure. The main findings of the study is that premature stimulation in patients with non-ischemic cardiomyopathy causes progressive activation delay, which can easily be quantified by measuring the pace crest duration after a 400 millisecond drivetrain and single extra stimulus. And these pace crest duration restitution parameters are associated with inducibility of polymorphic VT in these patients, and progressive activation delay is associated with not delayed enhancement on the MR, but to long fixed strands of fibrosis on endomyocardial biopsies, but not to the overall area percentage, suggesting that the geometry of fibrosis causes is linked to the arrhythmogenity in these patients. Mm-hmm.
So these are very intriguing and interesting findings. And do you think that these findings also pertain to patients with ischemic cardiomyopathy?
It's a little bit difficult to say because the scar is mostly different in these patients compared to the non-ischemic cardiomyopathy, especially the more dense scar after infarct. So, yeah, it's really difficult to say. We don't know if we can really compare these data and say something about ischemic patients. Mm-hmm.
So what are the clinical implications of your study? What would you like to have the clinicians to remember as a take-home message?
The clinical implications is that progressive activation delay after premature stimulation is linked to inducibility of ventricular arrhythmias in these patients. And these parameters are very easy to measure after EP study by an electrophysiologist in a couple of minutes, and gives valuable information about the progressive activation delay after premature stimulation and the risk for polymorphic ventricular tachycardia. And whether these CRS restitution parameters say something about the spontaneous occurrence of ventricular arrhythmias requires further study with longer duration and a larger sample size.
Thank you for sharing your research with us. You have heard Jeroen Fenlet and Valentina Kutyipra from ESC TV in London.